I was, the Army joined me and asked me to and I was a helicopter crew chief, and Fort Rutherford today continues that great legacy. After finishing my Army career, then I joined the United States Coast Guard. And you know, several have mentioned Dr. Martin Luther King, and one of the other things that he said is that you cannot teach what you do not know, and you cannot lead where you did not go. And so I am proud to be standing here with my colleagues because we know how tough it is when you are a stranger and people don't help. We know how tough it is, especially for young people. It's been said that part of the legacy of this country, the greatest legacy, I would say, is that we are a nation that welcomes immigrants. We're a nation built by immigrants. We're a nation whose legacy is immigration. And so we should not tolerate turning this, our great legacy and our world upside down by a few people in different states. We already heard we cannot afford to have 50 different immigration policies. That's not who we are. That's not respecting the Constitution. So we're here today to listen to the stories that are so similar to Arizona and Georgia, where I can tell you a number of us have accompanied Luis in different parts of his journey. We have a tremendous amount of respect for him because he has never let go of this issue. But today, as a former Border Patrol chief, I can tell you, chiefs and sheriffs, heads of different law enforcement entities, do not want the additional responsibility of determining immigration status because it betrays the reason that they're successful in their communities. Luis mentioned El Paso is the safest city in the country. We're proud of that. Both the sheriff and the chief of police have said publicly, have stood up publicly and said, that's not our job. That is a federal responsibility. And so it undermines our international credibility when, and we don't know what drives some of these laws. There are different opinions on that. But we should never, ever have these laws step in between the trust of the law enforcement leadership and the law enforcement agencies and the community that they are charged to serve and to protect. That also is a betrayal of our communities. So I'm pleased to be here. I want to hear the testimony, and I promise you that all of us here are committed to writing this injustice. Thank you.